Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Lands of Lore 3. Last time we advanced in the Thieves Guild. We have earned some new skills. We've earned the Sniper skill and the Death Strike skill. The Death Strike enables us to kill things in a single hit, whilst the Sniper lets us zoom in on our targets and create that perfect kill. However, the controls are kind of inverted and weird, so that's not too helpful. Anyways, off of the back of that, we've now been instructed to go and meet Lena, the head of the Thieves Guild, who's waiting out the back somewhere, presumably here. There she is.
Copper, hey, please howdy, hey. Come in. Since we have never officially met, I'm Lena.
Glad to make your acquaintance.
Welcome to the Bacchanal, and thank you for getting that pardon. We've got a man held hostage by the Dark Army. The pardon will complete the ransom. What? You look surprised.
This is somewhat awkward, but I had not thought of the pardon falling into enemy hands.
Oh, don't worry. While the boundary between friend and enemy may be indistinct, we'd never let a pardon go. It's a ruse, actually. And we're going to make a switch as soon as their expert verifies the goods. We'll give you the pardon back afterwards if you're that worried about it.
Thank you, and excuse me. I'm only 16, you know. I've still got a few things to learn about this world.
No need to apologize. I'd have done the same. As long as you're back here, feel free to look at the goods.
Is this an inner shop, sort of?
Yes. That and our jewelry work area. We remount gemstones, melt gold pieces, and other jewelry work.
The Bacchanal gets more interesting every time I visit.
Okay. So, there's nothing to actually do here just yet, but what we can do... I never actually noticed that the door doesn't go all the way to the ceiling. I think if we re-enter, we actually get our next quest.
Hello, Copper. How's it going outside? Is everybody off the streets?
Buck and Barnabas are still open, but everybody else is hiding, I think.
Good. I wish you'd hurry up and close those portals.
Sorry. It's not like this is my fault.
I didn't mean to imply that it was. I just wish you'd hurry. A lot of people will get hurt if it gets much worse.
I don't mean to be a prophet of doom, but my guess is that it'll get worse before it gets better. I've still got 3 missing pieces of the mirror to find.
Maybe not. Well, we're going to get another Thieves Guild quest at some point anyway. While we're here, we're also going to buy the Musk of Shadows.
I'd like to buy this, please.
My pleasure.
And we're going to pop it on instead of the Valkyrie chart. In fact, actually, we're so high thief level, we probably don't even need the Skull Key anymore. Did we check out the hidden area in the keep? I can't remember. Let's run back and have a look at that and see. So, the Mask of Shadows, what that does for us is that will make us invisible whenever we stand still. And that's going to come in very useful later on. So we're kind of getting pushed around. No one really knows where we are, but it's all good. We can even attack and stay invisible as well, which is pretty awesome. We're death blowing all over the place. Talking of blow... Oh no, we have to attack it. Oh no, we can blow it. There we go. Let me get rid of the wrapper that was on my desk so I don't blow that over anymore. Open chest. Anything interesting in here? The lore stone. That's kind of it. So. Let's... Oh, he didn't die. Okay,
nice.
Interesting. Okay, let's head to the keep so I can just double check whether or not we had a look at that level 20 grate and had a look and see if we could open that other place in there yet. These guys are lasting. They got some serious health on them. We need to get ourselves a better ranged weapon. The only downside is we don't actually come across the best ranged weapon in the game until much, much later. So we're going to have to make do with the great bow shift for now. Which isn't too bad. It's still a pretty decent bow. You know, it's good being able to attack your enemies with their weaknesses directly. It means we don't have to carry so many items around as well. I think it's just because these roaches are much bigger. They're got more health. It's okay though, because like I say, we are giving the death blow all over the place. Even the occasional backstab as well. Where are these roaches at? There you are. And we can also one-hit kill with our sword anyways. I believe to the left here is our way back up. That's him out. I think we need to raise the ladder. There we go. Lovely. Let's go and have a quick look. And then we're going to move on into the woods and actually go and take care of our next portal world. We're certainly going to begin to anyways. So, I'm sure we did, but I just need to double check for my own sense of well-being, basically. I'm sure we did, but we'll have a look and see anyways.
Locked.
Yes, it's still locked. Okay, good to know. That's fine. Let's go then into the woods and crack on. We're going to go to the next portal world now, as there's nothing else for us to do right now.
Going out if I could, sir. What is your name, anyway?
Elliot, sir.
Nice to meet you, Elliot. I'm Copper LeGray.
And who doesn't know that, sir? I can see what you're up to. And it's you gonna save Gladstone all by yourself while Lord Jerin has His Highness running off to battle stragglers from the Dark Army.
Hmm. Thank you, Elliot. I'm glad at least somebody appreciates my situation.
You may pass, sir.
Awesome. Thank you, Elliot. Let's do this. Let's see if that slithery thing happens again.
Not exactly stalwart fighters.
That is so weird. I will need to definitely check that back in post for the previous episode, see if I can work out what that is. Oh! Hang on a moment. What's happened down at the docks? It's all frozen over. The boat's gone. Well, that's not very good. Oh, and there's wharf rats around as well. That's a pretty intense noise. I don't think I've ever heard the noise that they make like that before. That's... And I think it's just solely wharf rats now. How did that one die? I wasn't even attacking him. It's all money at the end of the day, innit? Look at that. Making the money. Especially since I spent it all on that Mask of Shadows. I'm sure there was a wharf rat in here. Never mind. Do we get any extra items in that from these? Because we did initially. Yeah, look at that. The items have respawned. Cool. Good to know. Anyway, this isn't what we're here to do today, so let's not dilly-dally anymore around the docks. I was just distracted by the snow. Forgot that the docks got all snowy when the portals started leaking. Hang on. Thank you. Gotta stop for the break. Okay. Same as last time, anything interesting happens in the woods, I will keep it in. Otherwise, we will cut straight to our next portal, which will be at that really uninteresting and boring old quarry that has absolutely nothing to do with anything. Oh, hi. Right, here we are. Quarry is coming up on the right, I believe. Yep, there it is. Oh,
although I do suppose a whole horse without any potatoes,
have a brook flounder.
Would be sort of a boring meal.
Gives us an eye in the back of our head so we can see what's going on behind us. Really cool. And we can see the world glitch out as well. That is nice. Good to know. Right, I'm going to do a quick old save right here. And I'm also going to take my armor off because you can kill Rynn. Which we don't want to really do. We can do. It'll do nothing for us, but we can attack Rynn. And there's some acid down there. Acid's not very good for us, but it's okay. We have a poison shield. Hello, Rynn.
You are going inside?
I had intended to. Is there some reason I shouldn't?
It is dangerous. The creatures fly, but have no wings. I fought the creatures, but they do not die. They have a way to return to life.
You mean they have the ability to regenerate themselves?
Yes. If you must fight them, you would want to destroy the devices first.
Regeneration devices?
Yes. Regeneration
devices. See if we get some
devices.
Top quality flying animation here.
You should also destroy the eggs, too.
Well, thanks for the advice, Brother Rynn.
Good. But I am not your brother.
Yep, there we go. Oh, look at that. Perfect. We are under attack, but priorities. Cyrus can take care of our assailant for now. We are gonna enjoy this. Look at him go. Oh, where's the way out? There he is. Haha. Oh, he's still going. He's still going. He's still going. He is still going. There he goes. Oh, yes. Look at the flying. Where is he? There he goes. He's still going. I'm assuming he's still going. We can't see for the trees, but... Oh, there he goes. Look at that. I think that's all we're going to get out of Rynn's flying now. Right. Who's attacking us? Oh, hi. That is a Rift Hound. This is going to be our main source of Hound's Hearts. Remember, we touched upon those in a previous episode where we can eat them and they will just spawn in items. Well, that's that. We're going to make a nice little collection of those now because Rift Hounds are going to get to be pretty common. Right, let's go to the Ruloy homeworld.
Still active.
Welcome to the Ruloy homeworld.
Wow. This looks like we're on another planet.
I sense activity inside.
Well then, let's go see what we can find in the mountain.
Suits me fine.
So, someone's on various videos I've watched of this and things like that. Someone makes the very good point of, how would Copper know what a different planet is? This is, presumably, medieval England. He's, not necessarily going to be aware of what other planets are.
Scavengers.
We're going to take a set of scavenger eyes just so that we have that entry in our item book. And this is also a level that suffers from not having any music if you attack things. So we're just going to do that and kickstart it again. Fortunately, we don't get to any serious combat until much later. What's down here? I don't know if I've ever been down here. This just looks like a scavenger nest or something. I don't know. Do not know. Oh well, let's wander around. Oh, are you kidding? I'll be back when the dog shuts up. Sorry about that interruption. I think we're okay now. Went next door, posted a rather angry letter through the letterbox, letting them know how unhappy I was that their dog was interrupting my day once again. Still, never mind. Let's crack on anyway with the Ruloy homeworld and see what it is that's going to be befalling us here. So there's a lot... Well, no, there isn't actually. There isn't a lot going on currently, but that could all be about to change. So, can we... We can't get an eye up over the wall here and have a little nosy around, see what's going on outside the hive. But that's probably for the best. I'm noticing this big old kind of hole on the map here. Is this anything? Like, anything up? No. Don't know what that's all about. Never mind. We need to head this way into the next part of the homeworld. Take a lot of fall damage for no real discernible reason. It's unfortunate, but nothing can be done about that. We should, while we're here, prep our poison shield. This is going to be very helpful to us. We might even have to load up a damage shield as well, because we're going to be getting to the real meat and potatoes now of the Ruloy homeworld. These scavengers are completely harmless. We don't need to worry too much about those. Can I make it up there, I wonder? If we time this jump just right, maybe we can. Oh, that wasn't timed right, but I feel like we would be able to. Awesome, okay. Let's have a look around here, see if there's anything sneaky. It's looking like there might be. This is a new experience for all of us, ladies and gents.
That pool smells like acid. Yikes! Those must be eggs in there.
Acid.
Yeah.
Eggs.
So we have the pool of acid that we don't want to step in, and some eggs right there, which we've now destroyed. Oh, but there doesn't appear to be anything else in here. That's a shame. I thought we'd stumbled across a really interesting secret. Still, never mind. Maybe something more will come of it. Oh, there's that down there, okay. I must admit, I don't recognise that. Okay, let's move on and have a look down here then. So I don't think this is part of the main way. Okay, let's not give up hope on the secret just yet. We might have found something cool. We're going to destroy all these eggs though, because we don't want any more of these creatures sort of hatching out and doing things. Now these don't stack up very far, but as far as I recollect, they are worth a little bit of money. Oh, look at that, we skipped the damage and poison tick there, that's good. Okay, but nothing else in here. Nothing else. Okay, well, not to worry, we've found somewhere new, done some new things. That's good enough for me. That's pretty decent. Let's continue onwards. I guess they kind of thought about that the player might be able to get there, but didn't really anticipate many people would try, so didn't do too much about fixing it. We can get up here as well. I don't know how useful this will be for us. I don't know if we're getting into all sorts of places we shouldn't be able to now, but let's explore until we're told otherwise. That's my logic on things. Continue to do it till someone tells you not to. Advice for life there. Where does this take us to? I feel like this takes us back to the start here.
Boy, now I okay. Wish I had packed a lunch.
Hi. Hi, guy. I think we can eat the scavenger eyes. We can't. Oh, you have to throw those. Like that, and they explode. That's what it is. Okay, can't do anything with those. Let's eat the dragon meat. Yeah, let's do that. Okay. That's good. Okay, good. We are learning. We are exploring. That is what is important. Muy potente, as I think they say in Polish. Something akin to that anyways. So, yes, now we are getting to the meat and potatoes. Let's save. And move onwards. We're going to activate both of our shields here. And we want to tread carefully. Because the Ruloy will be about. Oh, he knows we're here. This kind of termite tower thing. That's fine though, because we can easily take that out.
Spit.
Death blow. What's poisoning me? I thought the scavengers were supposed to be docile. They seem to be attacking me. Interesting. Get rid of that. Okay, things are taking a bit of an odd turn around here, but that's okay. Like I say, we're going to kill the eggs, run through acid, look out for all the poison and stuff, the scavengers everywhere. Going to kill the eggs, grab up some of the rainbow crystals, and see what's what. Oh, we've been poisoned. That's okay. Poison can be cured with a poison shield. Yeah, we can take a couple more of the rainbow crystals, because I think they're worth a little bit as well. Good, we'll take some of these. Quite a lot of the items in the Ruloy world are magic-based. So we will be taking these to the Talamari. Can we slide under here? It's not recommended, but we can. We were drowning a little bit as well. The light's not really doing anything for us. And that just brings us out here. Okay. Fair dues. I thought it probably would, but a little bit of exploration never hurt anyone. Gonna take another one of those. Okay. I mean, I say exploration never hurt anyone. We got pretty badly injured there, but it's okay. Let's negotiate down here. We will probably come across the Ruloi at some point. I hope we do anyway, because I'm getting quite concerned at the lack of Ruloi at the moment. It's very uncharacteristic. Normally we will have encountered them by now. Cyrus can also poison shield us if we're not paying that much attention. That was me that time, and I think Cyrus applied one a little bit too late to us as well, but that's okay. I haven't really got time to be fussing around with the eggs here. Like, yeah, it's just going to take time for no real benefit, and besides, it doesn't actually look like they're even spawning anything. See, look, we got the Ruloi drones in our book here, so it reckons we've come across them. I mean, we kind of have, in the sense of that's what the creature was that was floating around in that jail. So we have technically, I guess, come across one, but we haven't actually had an encounter with one. We haven't actually attacked one yet. We don't need to kill the termite hills either, but it can be useful too, because they do fire out those plasma balls. They can be kind of damaging. So it is good just to do a little bit of tidying up as you're wandering around, but there's nothing too dangerous about it. Can I? Okay, I can't recast them to reset the count, so we just have to keep an eye on that for now. There still aren't any Ruloi. That is interesting. And really uncharacteristic as well. Very unusual not to have encountered a single one. Very unusual indeed. So we have a door right there, and we have another door over there that we can head into. It looks like loads of these eggs have already been destroyed for some reason by something. That is unusual. This whole world is relatively unusual. It's not behaving in the way in which I remember it ever behaving. Which is kind of concerning. I'm going to keep on using those words because those are the only ones I can think of to describe this. It's gotten me kind of unnerved. And there's a third door right there.
Spittle. Ooh,
taking a load of damage by just walking into that plasma pillar. Not recommended behaviour. Another termite hill. Okay. So now we have three ways to go. I think they all lead to the same place, so it doesn't actually matter too much. Oh, there's one. I can hear it attacking us. It sent this thing after us. So this is just going to cling on to us now and slowly damage us over time. There's not much we can do to shake it off. So we're just going to have to make do. Oh, here's one. And there he goes. Simple as that. Right. Let's save and move into the actual hive. Oh, there's another one. Okay.
We fight soon.
There we go. Take him out. That's fine. It's not giving us any music. That's not very nice. Because the music, as I seem to recall, is actually quite good for this section as well. So let's try and kick it back into life. Yeah, there we are. It will, of course, die the moment we get into another bout of conflict. But for now, at least. So the reason why I've taken the Mask of Shadows is obviously because we go temporarily invisible when we stand still, and that lets us hide from the Ruloi just a little bit. So there's obviously another one floating around over there, we just saw him fly past. He's probably going to attack us. Probably would have been better to just buy an invisibility spell rather than rely on the mask, but where'd he go? So that's where one of the doors would have let us in. Oh, there he is. Okay, he's spotted us. That's fine. We're just charging. So we can kind of outrun this plasma mess that he coats us in. But not forever. It will catch up with us and start damaging us. So we can outrun forever. Okay, I've got another creature now, and I think that's him floating around at the end of that corridor there. That's the Ruloy Warrior. We've only been fighting the drones at the moment. The Warrior is much tougher, but we do need to kill the Warriors because they have something that we need. There he is. Okay, he spotted us. That's a shame. Never mind. Better get some healing going. Should have bought better healing spells, I think. But hopefully this means he will stop attacking us. Because we're now invisible. He's going to float a bit nearer. And... pow! Pow! Look at that health. Look how much damage we're doing each time. Dang. How are you doing, Cyrus? How'd you take damage there? Are you okay? He's alright. Oh, look at that. I haven't got my armor on. No wonder I'm taking so much damage. Jeez. Okay. That'll help a bit. Where are you? There he is. Okay. That's cool. We can deal with this. Easy. Now then. We have a load of corridors. All these chambers are kind of interconnected. And we need to explore them all to find where we need to be going. So there's somewhere new down here, which presumably leads to that third door that we think we found. And keep that damage shield up just because I don't like the amount of damage we're taking in here at the hands of these guys at the moment. So anything we can do to nullify that will be greatly, greatly appreciated. So nothing here, which means that we can crack back on this way and get into the meat of the Ruloy homeworld. Oh, now who's seen me? That'll be you, I suppose. Come on then. Nice. Nothing to me. And him as well? Okay. There we go. Good. On that note, we're going to see you in the next episode and we're going to continue to explore the Ruloy homeworld. So, until then, thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.